Good afternoon and welcome to our DMACC Career Discovery event. We are excited to be live here at fashion designer Gretchen Bohling's design studio. We thank you all for being here. Our hope is that these events are linking your education and your career interests with businesses and professionals right here in Central Iowa. So before I introduce Gretchen a little bit more, I would like to say hello. My name is Jill Hoik and I am the Work-Based Learning Navigator at DMACC. And so I will be your host today. And so if you have any questions at all for Gretchen during our live tour, she's gonna show us around her design studio and talk just a little bit about her background and her profession as a fashion designer and business owner. Just let me know in the chat, or you can kindly unmute yourself too that way. So without further ado, I'm gonna film Gretchen now. So I'm gonna turn it over and film her, and we'll kind of get to know her a little bit. And again, we want you to engage with her. So let me know what questions you have. But let me turn this back around. So this is Gretchen Bohling, and she is a fashion designer and a business owner. So we are in her design studio right now. And like I said, we're going to show you some of her pieces and her space here in just a little bit. But I kind of wanted to sit down with her and get to know her a little bit before we take a tour. So Gretchen, can you just kind of talk a little bit about how you got into fashion design? Is it something that, you know, you were interested in as a little girl, or is it something that you kind of came upon later in life?
Yep. So I've always been interested in fashion ever since I was a little girl, you know, making clothes for my dolls and stuff, not like actually constructing and sewing them, but like always interested in style. So I went to college right out of high school for fashion design. And I went to school in Chicago at the Illinois Institute of Art, graduated with my BFA in fashion design. So specifically went to school for design, where I learned, you know, all the stuff on how to make clothes, construction, pattern making, that sort of thing. So yeah, it's always been something I knew I wanted to do, and specifically even having my business one day. So
awesome. And so you kind of talked a little bit about your education and training. Can you just go into specifics of like what your degree is in, like the name of it? Yep. And then you were in Chicago, correct?
Yep. So my degree is Bachelor's of Fine Arts in Fashion Design. So BFA Fashion Design. And I went to a three-year program year-round, so it's a four-year degree. Didn't know how to sew a lick of clothing before I went. I knew how to make like pillows and stuffed animals from home ec, but didn't really know how to do any of the actual professional construction. So I learned everything that I know and use today in college. So it was a super beneficial experience for me. Like I said, it was a three-year program specific for fashion design at my school. It was an art school in Chicago. So there were people there getting going to school for game art design and interior design, fashion design. There was a marketing and merchandising program. So I was close with my fashion design students. There was probably, my class was probably like 20 or 30, super small. And then the merchandising and marketing students started with us and then obviously branched off during the last parts of the degree where, you know, the design students went more into the construction, pattern making, and draping. Took design specialties classes. So we got to pick from like a handful of specialties, meaning like evening wear, children's wear, swimwear, sportswear. There was a millinery and a footwear one as well. So, and then onto the senior collection. So it was a really awesome program. I feel very fortunate to have gone there because I was telling Jill earlier that, like I said, also I learned everything that I know there. So I'm actually utilizing my degree because that's what I do. For work and for my business. So
yeah. And I do want to mention that Gretchen is an adjunct teacher for our DMACC program. She helps kind of with the sewing classes at DMACC. So just a little plug for us too. Yeah, we have a two-year program and Gretchen is kind enough to volunteer her time to be able to do that too. So what would you say is your biggest win so far in your career?
Ooh, that's a good question. I'd say my biggest win is finding a space here at my studio building, which we'll show you the space after this little interview part. But so to make a long story short, I moved from Chicago to Des Moines about 5 years ago when I officially launched Gretchen Bohling Design, which is my business. And I did that purely because it's more affordable to live in Des Moines. And I grew up in Iowa, so it made sense. it was close enough to Chicago to go back and forth while I still had a lot of clients back there, while I was starting to build my client base in Des Moines. And then about a year or two after I moved to Des Moines, I found out about Mainframe Studios, which is where my studio is. It actually, the DMACC Fashion Institute has used it years past for their fashion gala. So some of you might know where Mainframe is. It's downtown Des Moines, right by Methodist Hospital. But it's just a studio building that's full of all different types of art and all different types of artists. We have photographers, jewelers, painters, myself, so fashion, just a good array. And I'd say that's the biggest win because the building itself didn't open until 2017. And I got in right on that first wave of artists. There's been a huge waiting list of artists and they just opened the next floor. So we had a bunch more move in last March, which has been exciting. But that's the biggest win because the space allows me to have a separate space from, I was working out of my home. It allows me to have a separate space. It's a big space, which just helped me to expand. And, you know, just being in a building full of other artists, it's a great way to network and get my business name out there. So I'd say that's probably the biggest win.
Yeah. And I know I'm just so excited to show you guys. This space is also very beautiful. So we will definitely show you that too, as well. What would you say is for young students looking into this profession, what are some personality traits that you think that students should maybe have before they enter into the fashion world?
That's a super good question. And one that I think, you know, people have this like connotation about fashion, you have to have style or you have to have like be super outgoing or whatever, you have to fit into this mold, but it's really not that way. From a behind the scenes, you know, viewpoint, like designer, like if you look at certain designers, like they're not, some of them don't even like, they just wear all black. So you don't even worry about like style too much per se. But when it comes to more personality, I'll talk a little bit about my personal experience. So right after college, I worked in retail management. I did wholesale for a while and then personal styling. And when I was in my personal styling job, that job, so I consider myself an introvert. I don't remember the Myers-Briggs test, INFP or whatever, but I have an introverted personality. So it's always been hard for me to like get myself out there. It's super, super outside of my comfort zone. And when I had that job as a personal stylist, it essentially forced me to go outside of my comfort zone because it was a sales job. I was trying to get clients to sell clothes to, right? And so I remember in my training class, they made us do something called prospecting, which literally means like go sit at a coffee shop and like find somebody and walk up to them and like get them to come in and sell them clothes. And it's like super awkward to do. It was really hard for me, but you know, I did it. I learned a lot from it. So even me being an introvert doing fashion, but also like having my own business in fashion, which means that I am in charge of like making my own money, which means I can't just sit here and wait for people to come to me. You know, I still made it happen. So I really think there's not any one type of personality that would succeed in the fashion industry. I think it just takes a lot of hard work, a lot of tenacity. I mean, you just have to like do the work and just kind of dedicate yourself to it and figure out what specifically your kind of goals are. I know a lot of fashion design, you know, people think, oh, well, you don't actually have to make the clothes. I do because that's one of my passions, but you know, with a fashion design degree or even merchandising, you're doing just one piece of the puzzle that is the umbrella of fashion design. So you don't even really need to have sewing experience. I mean, it's helpful. And if you go to school for fashion design, you will have that experience, but you might just be doing technical sketches if that's your path, or you might be doing, you know, sample making, which then you would incorporate sewing. So it even from the technical aspect, you don't necessarily need to have all of the things like knowing how to sketch and knowing how to sew and doing all that, you know. So
yeah, that's great. Yeah, when Gretchen and I were talking before this, she was, you know, really talking about how when she went to school, that's where she learned most everything she knows now. So I think that's a great thing to mention. So you'll probably laugh at this question just because there probably isn't really a typical day for you, but if you could just kind of walk me through what a day looks like for you. And I know it's probably different every day, which is maybe what makes it so exciting.
Yeah. And you're right. It is different every day, but generally I have fittings throughout the week. I try to schedule them during like keep my fittings to like Tuesdays, Thursdays, and then Saturdays. So I'll have, like yesterday I had a fitting for somebody who's a bridesmaid at a wedding. I spend most of my downtime sewing, so finishing, whether it's my tailoring and alterations clients, or if I'm working on a custom piece, or, you know, the new collection pieces in my private label collection, which I'll show you all that too. So a lot of the downtime is spent sewing at my sewing machine, or pattern making if I'm doing a custom piece. When I meet with my custom clients, they'll come in and we'll sit at the table, much like Jill and I are doing, and we'll just have a consultation. I'll kind of make some rough sketches. We'll talk about fabric. So that's something that I do frequently. I do a lot of different events. So last weekend I participated in the Iowa State Fashion Show. So last week my focus was on getting everything ready for that event. So yeah, it is all over the place. I also teach sewing lessons, so those are scheduled in there as well. And then in the fall, I teach the course Intro to Garment Construction up at DMACC and Ankeny campus. So that is usually a 3-hour class twice a week where I kind of carve out time in my schedule to go up there and do that. So yeah, it's kind of all over the place, but it's generally fittings, time spent sewing, pattern making, and then, you know, just prepping for events. Every first Friday of the month, we do an open studio event at Mainframe. So they open the build, keep the building open late to invite, you know, the public in. With COVID, everybody wears masks and kind of reserves a time. So it's been nice to kind of get that back on the roster, because it does help with exposure and, you know, people seeing my brand and stuff like that. So that's every first Friday of the month.
Yeah. So very, very busy. Well, we are, I'm just so excited to show her space. So we're going to go ahead and start that little tour. But again, for those of you who are joining us, feel free to ask any questions that you have. So where would you like to begin?
All right. Well, I guess we'll just start kind of where we're at.
So yeah.
If you want to show them this part.
Yeah.
So this is where I do my fittings. So we've got a nice mirror fitting room that kind of goes down when I have clients in it. So they'll slip into their stuff and fit them real quick. And then the table over here where Jill and I were sitting is where I'll do my consultations. So I'm usually sitting with a sketchbook and fabric swatches, and we're just kind of designing and doing all that fun stuff. Right here is my rack of my private label collection. So that's one kind of aspect of my business. It's the collection that I design and pattern make and sell under my name. And everything is handmade to order. So this is the current collection for spring, summer. And I just do one sample in each piece, and people can order it on my website based on a size chart, or they can come in and get measurements taken specifically to their size. Since everything's made to order, it's super customizable.
Can you tell them your website?
Yep. So my website is just GretchenBohling.com. So first name, last name.com.
Awesome. I just want to show some of these pieces up close because they're adorable.
Yeah, this plaid is the it fabric for the collection. So,
and then do you want to talk about this piece? We were talking about it. How?
Yep. So one of my missions as a designer is to be sustainable. So it's kind of the main mission that you'll see on my website and pretty much in all of my social media. So this is a silhouette that's always in my collection. So here's one that I always offer in white. This one you'll notice is kind of patchwork. So this is made using fabric scraps from other pieces. So I don't throw any fabric away, just because, you know, the fashion industry is actually the number two behind oil that causes the most pollution in the earth. Wow. So I keep all that fabric. The bigger pieces go into stuff like this. And then smaller pieces, I actually stuff into like four poofs and stuff like that. So I literally try not to throw anything away, even like threads. But yeah, so the patchwork Alicia top is a fun one. And when somebody orders that, they're all unique, because obviously scraps change based on what I have. But yeah, so sustainability is like the main goal, which is why I do everything made to order. I'm not ordering 50 yards of fabric. I just kind of place my fabric order when an order comes in. Easier on inventory. It's more cost effective for my business. And then same thing with, you know, doing the tailoring and alterations. I try to promote people coming in and fixing things before tossing them out.
That's great.
Yeah. And then back here is the actual workspace. So I've expanded my studio, so we'll go next door where my old space was. That's where I'm going to now be teaching my sewing classes and private lessons. So this is the studio space. You'll see my machines that I use. The straight stitch right here is the one that does most of the work. and then the serger and whatnot. So
my ironing board back there. And then I'm still kind of moving into the space. I'll have shelves over on this blank white wall where I'll store my fabric and whatnot. All my tools over there, some threads and stuff like that. And then the work table here, which is where I stand and do all the pattern making and cutting things out. And you see, I'm working on tailoring a suit. So,
awesome.
And then the desk over there where I do emails and all the fun stuff like accounting and marketing and all that cool stuff. So
yeah, and she has a pretty awesome view too. Yeah. So
yeah.
Let me know if you guys have any questions. I'm monitoring the chat. So let me know. Yeah. Okay, we're gonna pop on our masks. We have to go out into the hallway. So just bear with us here.
So we'll show you guys kind of my display. So I have pictures of the custom work that I do with my clients. And this is my actual fashion illustration from when I was in college. So that's my first fashion sketches that I did.
Oh my goodness. That is awesome.
And then these are pieces of art from other artists in the building. And then a couple of my custom pieces in the white frames. So the custom pieces that I make, obviously I don't get to keep, they go to the client that orders them. So what I do is just make sure I take pictures and then I frame them and put them on my wall.
Someone asked, can you sign up for sewing lessons on your website?
Yep, you can. There's a special tab that's under sewing lessons and that will give you all the instructions on how to reach out and get that done. Awesome. And my sewing lessons I've taught privately in the past, but now that I have the new space, which we'll show you, I'm going to do more classes. So it'll be like 5 to 8 people in one class and different workshops too. So that's awesome. Something to look forward to.
Yeah. Good question.
Okay. So these are some custom work that I've done. So this is the patchwork Alicia, which you noticed from the inside. Did this awesome custom Letterman jacket for a client. So it's actually reversible. There's a different design on the inside that I actually sourced one of my old interns who does hand embroidery. She did the inside of it. So that was fun for her. This is my sister's. I made her wedding dress. So custom piece, custom bodysuit that I did for somebody. And then around here, we'll just show you. This is kind of my...
I wanted to show this, so.
Basically, this is just what I would consider my storefront.
Sorry.
So that people know it's me. So I just blew up some of my sketches and then obviously put my name up there. So that's what you see when you get off the elevator, which shows you where I'm at. And we'll walk down the hall to the sewing studio where the classes will be. So I'll show you some more. These are all custom pieces that I've done throughout the years. So you'll see a wide array. It's not just wedding dresses. I even do like sweatpants and stuff. A lot of my clients will come, they'll have like a favorite pair of pants that they've had for years that are starting to fall apart. So I'll duplicate those and things like that. I've done Halloween costumes and all sorts of different things. I always say that anything's possible.
Absolutely. Sorry, I'm trying to go slow so you guys don't get seasick here.
Here's a Halloween costume I did. I'm a genie.
Cute.
And this one was a sustainable collection I did. So these are thrifted items. You'll see this was a quilt that I kind of cut up and used in all these pieces. So just to promote sustainability.
Did you find it difficult to grow a client base here in Des Moines? I've heard often that fashion design is something done mostly in big cities such as New York. Did you find that to be true, or do you believe a career in fashion can be achieved anywhere?
I think that's a great question, and actually something Jill and I talked about before we got on the call. I think it's a misconception that it's hard to do fashion anywhere but New York or LA. I think with the fashion industry being so accessible online, you can do it from anywhere. And
when I first moved from Chicago, obviously I had my client base from my previous jobs that I used to sustain myself while I was building a client base here. But I mean, with social media and websites and just Facebook and all of that, it's pretty easy to build a client base. And a lot of it is word of mouth. I mean, if you have good work and your clients are happy, they're going to refer their friends and their family to you. So it's not super hard. And especially because fashion can be accessed from anywhere, it doesn't really matter where it's being made. People need to wear clothes everywhere. There's formal events everywhere in the country. So even with Des Moines, like there's tons of, it's a huge like gala city. There's lots of insurance and finance here. So there's people with money. Which is true pretty much everywhere you go. So
yeah, that was a really good question.
So this is kind of barren looking. I'm still under construction here or not under construction, but this is going to be the new sewing classroom. So it'll be equipped with its own cutting table. I've got an industrial for the students, and then I have sewing machines. I just need to get tables for them. So I'm kind of in the process of getting that set up, hopefully gearing to launch actual classes by the summer, but still doing private lessons because I can do that in the other space. But you can kind of see that's my fabric stash and patterns. So I'll have that on the other side kind of similarly. And then there'll be space for my students to have fittings if they need to up here with another fitting room. Just like you would in a sewing lab at school. That's kind of the idea. And then these are some super old samples that I've just kept over the years.
I know you said that you didn't really know too much about, you know, well, you liked it and you were passionate about it, but is sewing something you wish you kind of had a little bit more experience in before you went to college? Or what's something that you, what advice would you give students right now that are young and thinking about this profession? Is there anything that you would have done differently or wish you would have known a little bit more about?
So I think that as far as doing something differently, I went to an art school, which was super expensive. And I think that was because I was the oldest of my siblings and the first one to go to college, and my father didn't know anything about visiting colleges. So we just kind of went with that. But you can just as easily get the same education at somewhere like DMACC where they have the program, and then kind of go from there if you want to go to get your bachelor's at Iowa State or do an art school. There's no right or wrong way. I do think, as far as my education, I'm super happy with what I went with. It would have just been nice to have a little bit more knowledge on just college in general, I guess, which isn't really up to me, I guess. More like what your career advisors might help you with in high school. And when you do have those advisors in college, I definitely say utilize them because they know what they're talking about and they've helped students like yourselves with their pathways. So that's one thing I would have wished I would have known more about. But as far as like sewing and all of that, I knew nothing on constructing clothing. And I don't think that really mattered because I learned everything that I know now that I'm using in college, and you know, I've been a success. So it's funny because I have a dress that I made to try to get a scholarship for my school, and I keep it in a bag because it reminds me of how far I've come, but it's literally like a tube with no shape. And then it was like pearled sleeves on like stretchy elastic, so it like doesn't even hang right. It's just, it humbles me to know where I've come from. So.
Yeah. That's great. Do you use a lot of like math, or is there any courses that, you know, they could be taking that would maybe help them in any way?
That's a good question. So math, yes, I use a lot of math, but it's specifically like fractions and decimals when it comes to measuring and like adjusting patterns. So, you know, like definitely don't discount like those gen eds. Even like when I was in college and we had to take costume history, it was really, really informative because you learn like the history of why garments are made a certain way, like why men's dress shirts button opposite from women's, because women used to have people dress them so that they're the way that the hands and functionality of it works. So it's just like really cool, interesting things like that you might not pick up if you didn't take those like gen eds and, you know, classes that don't have the non-studio classes, which might not be as fun for some people, but are still super beneficial. And yes, the math, definitely use that every day, but it's typically just fractions and decimals.
But you're basically saying if you hear of a student say I'm terrible at math, that's okay.
Yes, it's not like I hate math.
Okay.
It was not my strong suit. I've always been more of a creative, left brain person.
Yep.
And hated math. I mean, just didn't have any desire or whatever for it, but I do fine with it. Now I'm pretty good at decimals and fractions, as long as it's in the inch.
Yes. For those of you that are on the call, is there any part of fashion that you guys are the most interested in? Or maybe she could speak about some of the stuff that you guys are interested in too. So if you guys want to leave in the chat, maybe some things too, of things that you're interested in or what intrigued you about learning a little bit more about fashion design too. And then Gretchen, do you want to talk a little bit about your internships? I know she gets a lot of requests for them, and she has quite a few people wanting in for her internships, but I think it's really awesome that a one-man show has that opportunity.
Yeah. So I do offer an internship program for students that are looking for internships. I know DMACC specifically now has transitioned to just the summer term. So I just have space for one intern, just because it's just me, and my internship is structured more like a mentorship. So you're not necessarily like doing work for me, you're shadowing me in my work. So whether that's doing a fitting with me or me teaching you how to measure somebody correctly, or if you want to learn how I grade a pattern, which means make it bigger or smaller. So you're just pretty much there while I'm doing that, and I'm kind of mentoring you. Based on your goals and what you want to learn for your internship and for your future. Just one internship throughout the summer. I do offer like other times of year as well, but it doesn't always coincide with the class. So if somebody wants to just come do an internship or a job shadow, I'm always open to that.
What do you look for in an intern? Do they need to have previous fashion experience? Good question.
So it is nice because the internship spots are so like sought after. It seems weird to say that, but I do try to focus on somebody that's interested in the fashion industry or, you know, doing something within fashion, because that's really what I do on a daily basis. I've had interns in the past that are more interested in like photography, fashion photography, which would be something that would also, I think, blend well. And marketing as well. So like social media advertising and stuff like that, I think it's also a good fit. So it doesn't necessarily have to be the sewing and construction side of fashion, but if somebody is business-minded, that it would also be a good fit for somebody like that as well, because you're kind of seeing what goes on behind the scenes and the ins and outs of promoting and networking and even event planning, you know, things like that, because I do participate in a lot of events, so.
We have another question. Is there a place on your website to apply for an internship?
Yep, you can just go. There's a tab on my website. It's like about shop, blah, 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 contact. Just go to the contact one and put that you're looking for an internship, and that emails me directly.
Awesome. Yeah. Would you be willing to do a session like this for a fashion class in the spring?
Yeah. Absolutely. I love talking to people and showing them what I do, because I feel like going back to the question about fashion in Des Moines and does that make sense? I think people are surprised that, I don't know if surprised is the right word, but it's rare that you see a fashion designer in Des Moines, but you know, we do exist, and there's actually a very huge art community in Des Moines, and being in mainframe has been really fun to kind of show and support and like show people that we are here, and Des Moines is really good for arts and even small business. I mean, there's a huge support for shopping small here and supporting small businesses. So we've got great neighborhoods like the East Village, where there's tons of cute boutiques, and Valley Junction and Mainframe, which is full of artists and small businesses as well.
That's awesome. Yeah, I think for me, I personally didn't know or realize how much beyond designing clothes that you do.
Yeah.
You know, when you just think of a fashion designer, you know, you put on quite a few other things, and just even like alterations and stuff. That's a huge business in itself that you do. Yeah. So I have learned a lot, but one last question for you, Gretchen. And again, we're going to kind of wrap up here. So if you guys have any last questions, please leave them in the chat, but just for these students that are logging in right now, what advice would you give them for wanting to move forward in the fashion industry, whether it's this route or maybe just anything other that has to do with merchandising or anything like that? What advice would you give them?
I think the best thing you can do for yourself, aside from, you know, learning whatever craft or whatever, you know, business mind you want, is to network and get the experience. So whether that's doing job shadowing or interning or just wherever you work, it's invaluable, because, you know, that paired with an education is what shapes you for, you know, the career world, whether you decide to go somewhere corporate or whether you decide to do small business. So my path was college, and I did about 3 internships while I was in college. Got experience in wholesale, which is, you know, the designer, between the designer and the retailer, so that I knew kind of how that worked, all the markups and everything like that. Did retail management, so I learned kind of, at that job, I learned how boutiques make money and why you have to sell so much, because profit and loss and all that stuff. Then I did personal styling, which is kind of what I talked about earlier, where I learned how to go get those sales, like get my client books and like make sales, because my livelihood depended on it. And then eventually, you know, doing my small business. So it's just a lot of getting that experience and just kind of sucking up as much as you can from, you know, your mentors and anyone that you know is in the industry. Just ask questions and just get yourself out there. And that's the best advice I could give.
Yeah, that's great advice. Well, we will wrap up. Gretchen, thank you so much for your time today. It has been wonderful being live in her studio. This will also be recorded for you students, because there's some that couldn't attend that signed up. So we will have a recording of this too as well for you to access at any time. But thank you all for attending. And thank you so much, Gretchen, for being here with us and letting us into your studio.
Yep. Welcome. Thanks for coming.
Thanks, guys.